Hello everyone, this is the Sammy Classic Sonic Fan, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about the first truly open world Sonic game, and that is Sonic Frontiers, and the new trailer that was just revealed for it. I have yet to talk about this game at all on my channel due to the hiatus I took, and they didn't reveal any actual gameplay footage in this trailer, but based on the cinematics they showed, there is plenty to talk about already, and I'm going to be sharing my opinions on it. I wanted to have this video out sooner, but my work schedule kind of wouldn't allow it, but that's okay, because we're gonna talk about it today, so I hope you enjoy the video.
Okay, so let's start off with the most important aspect of the game, and that is the character design, okay? Just kidding. But, although, if we do want to discuss the character design, I kind of noticed that when the trailer focuses on Sonic's face, you can tell he's a little bit more detailed than usual, almost like how he looks in the Sonic movie. Okay, well, maybe not quite as detailed, but you know what I'm saying. Like, you can see some of, like, the individual quills and whatnot. I just found that interesting. But overall, Sonic looks the same as he usually does. He looks fine. So yeah, we didn't see any actual gameplay footage in this trailer, which makes sense. I didn't think we would, because back when the game was first revealed in June, Takashi Iizuka, or someone like that, said that the game reveal was a bit premature. Nevertheless, we got to see how some of the locations look in this game, and I don't think anyone is in disagreement that it looks amazing. It looks beautiful. You could make a good case for this being the best looking Sonic game to date. And it's not even finished yet. This is still clearly an early build of the game. You know, it's not actually going to come out until holiday season of next year. And even then, you know, it could be delayed, which, honestly, if you think about it, it's kind of a bummer that we've had to go this long without any, like, game content. I mean, we've gotten some things, like Team Sonic Racing, which was, it was okay. I ended up buying it anyways, and it's a decent kart racer. Maybe not on the level of Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transformed, but it's fine. It's something other than Mario Kart, so there you go. And then we got Colors Ultimate, which, you know, Colors is a good game in general. It's an 11-year-old game at this point, but, you know, Colors is a pretty good game. Some aspects of it might have not aged well, but it's still enjoyable. It's just a shame that all the bugs that were found in the initial version of the game sort of became like a source of amusement. I mean, I encountered a few glitches in the game myself, but you know, it's not all the time. It's kind of like when the Game Grumps played it. I think they might have found like maybe one or two glitches, but pretty much they just played that game because of all the notoriety surrounding it. But it's just funny how Sonic Colors Ultimate was supposed to be, like, the superior version of Sonic Colors, but you can't even really call it that. Even just looking at some fundamental issues, like how long the credits were, especially the period of time where no music is playing. I mean, yeah, recently they fixed a lot of the stuff wrong with it in a patch, but it's like, why even release it if it wasn't, like, up to par, you know? Like, did they not hire people to test this game? It's just confusing, I guess. It's almost like, you know, we're the ones who kind of have to point out the problems sometimes. The Sonic Origins Collection is coming out at some point next year? You know, you get your Sonic 1, you get your Sonic 2, those games have been ported countless times. I'm just excited to be able to play Sonic 3 and Knuckles on new hardware again. The reason they don't port that game nearly as often is because of, like, some of the licensing issues, I guess, with the music. But Sonic 3 and Knuckles is one of the best Sonic games ever made, and people should absolutely have a way of being able to experience it. That isn't, you know, just emulating it or buying an original Sega Genesis with the Sonic 3 and Sonic and Knuckles cartridges, which are pretty hard to come by. Whether or not Sega can sell me on Sonic Origins is dependent on if they include the Christian Whitehead versions of the games. Like, we need the mobile versions of those games to be playable on consoles. People have been asking for this for years. And how great would it be to get a Christian Whitehead version of Sonic 3 and Knuckles in addition to the Christian Whitehead versions of Sonic 1, Sonic 2, and Sonic CD? That would be great, and they could even add, like, certain things from Mania, like the drop dash. Heck, while you're at it, might as well even just add in Mighty and Bray to all four of those games. Also, it's unlikely, but it'd be nice if they added, like, the Game Gear versions of Sonic 1 and Sonic 2, and also games like Sonic Triple Trouble, Sonic Chaos, Sonic 3D Blast, the Saturn version. Please put in the Saturn version, not the Genesis version. A lot of people think 3D Blast is a bad game because they played the wrong version. Anyways, I'm kind of getting sidetracked. My point is, we haven't gotten much Sonic game content in recent years, which is strange considering how successful the Sonic movie is. Why wouldn't you capitalize on that? I know Sega's game development resources are a lot more limited these days. Nowadays, they can kind of only handle, like, maybe a couple of projects at a time. It's kind of sad, really, but yeah, I guess, you know, it's a matter of quality over quantity. I can't disagree with that. The only problem is we haven't gotten much quality in recent years either. I think I said this in the previous video, but aside from Sonic Mania, we really haven't gotten any good Sonic games since Sonic Generations, which is a 10-year-old game at this point. It's pretty ridiculous that Sega, after all this time, is still experimenting with Sonic in 3D and trying to figure out how to make Sonic work in 3D, when we kind of already know what works. I think the Sonic Adventure playstyle was a good playstyle for Sonic in 3D. I'm pretty sure the only reason Sega gave up on it was due to the negative reception of Sonic 06. But there's nothing inherently bad with that playstyle for Sonic. And then you have the boost gameplay for Sonic, which is a good playstyle to capture the high-speed thrills and precision-based platforming that Sonic is known for into a 3D space, more so than even the adventure games ever could. But the issue with the boost gameplay is that it doesn't really work on its own. That's why Sonic Colors had so much blocky 2D platforming, side-scrolling areas. Sonic Generations had classic Sonic. Sonic Lost World was a complete departure from that playstyle entirely, and Sonic Forces had both classic Sonic and the custom character. If the rumors about Sonic Frontiers are correct, then we can expect to be seeing the boost-style gameplay that was popularized by Sonic Unleashed, but they'll be separate from the open-world gameplay. And I like that idea a lot, actually. Not only is it a way to appeal to the fans of Sonic Adventure and modern Sonic at the same time, but it could also be a solution going forward for Sega in making Sonic thrive in a 3D platformer. That I've always disliked about the boost style gameplay is just that it never could really succeed in making Sonic's controls feeling as tight as I'd like for them to, in the same way that the Sonic Adventure games actually achieved in doing this. For instance, let's look back at Sonic Lost World. When I first played Sonic Lost World, believe it or not, I actually liked that game a lot. I liked how, in a way, they were sort of trying to mix elements of the classic Sonic games with the modern. Not only that, but the controls were difficult to learn as well as master. The physics fell off because Sonic doesn't really have consistent momentum, which sort of misses the point of them trying to bring classic Sonic into modern Sonic, harmonizing them as one in the first place. Honestly, Sonic Lost World's failure might be why classic Sonic was brought back in Sonic Forces, because they realized that classic and modern kind of have to be separate. Anyways, something that I liked about Sonic Lost World that I stand by to this day is that the controls were tighter than they had been in years. You know, I think Sonic Lost World was a step in the right direction in that regard. I think people were just disappointed at the prospect of Sega abandoning the boost gameplay entirely, but I doubt that was ever the intention. I think Sonic Lost World was just yet another example of Sega experimenting. This is sort of backed up by the fact that they never brought back the parkour system after Sonic Lost World, like it didn't appear in Sonic Forces in any way. I hope they put that into Sonic Frontiers, at least as like a sort of upgrade ability. And then Sonic Lost World also encouraged exploration. And this is sort of where that game's inspiration from the classic Sonic game sort of comes in. Aside from, you know, the badniks and how the environments looked. With all that said, let's shift back to talking about Sonic Forces. I'm sorry, not Sonic Forces, Sonic Frontiers. Now, looking through the trailer, you can sort of see that the visuals remind you of a certain other game that was innovative in the sense that it revolutionized open world adventure games. And it's been inspiring other game series to do similar things. Even other Nintendo IPs such as Mario with Super Mario Odyssey and Pokemon with Pokemon Legends, which is also in the works. Oh, and you could also say Kirby and the Forgotten Land, which I need to talk about that, by the way. I feel like I freaking prophesied that game in my video on Kirby that I made earlier this year. It's kind of funny, so I need to talk about that for sure in another video, of course. Anywho, the game, of course, that I'm talking about is Zelda Breath of the Wild. The way that Sonic Frontiers is designed based on the preview that we were given makes it look like the spitting image of Breath of the Wild. And you know what? That's not necessarily a bad thing. As long as that's inspiring the game to do that sort of thing in its own unique way. In a way that's unique to Sonic. And if there's anything that worries me about that game, it's mostly pertaining to that, because as I was looking at the trailer, I was, of course, amazed and pleased at how excellent it looked. I'm just so happy that Sega's putting this much effort into Sonic Frontiers, and it's not just a lazy game. I can tell they're really taking their time with this game, Which is why we've been waiting so long for a new Sonic game, and I'm really hoping that the payoff will be worth it, of course. But I'm just a bit worried because the way it looks doesn't remind me of Sonic. Some other YouTubers that have been covering Sonic Frontiers, which honestly, I feel bad that I'm so late to this because pretty much all the YouTubers I'm subscribed to have covered this trailer already. Even some YouTubers that aren't even, like, specifically Sonic YouTubers have talked about this, so I don't know. I just feel bad, I guess, but it is what it is. Anyways, some YouTubers that have covered this trailer have pointed out that there don't really appear to be features that are normally present in a Sonic game. Like, we're not seeing the loop-de-loops, we're not seeing Moto Bugs, we're not seeing Crab Meats, we're not seeing the Buzz Bombers, we're not seeing... I don't think I even saw any rings in this trailer. I mean, again, to be fair, it's an early build of the game, and this isn't any actual gameplay footage. It's just the general layout of the lands, pretty much. But then, looking at the giant robot thing that Sonic was... that he encountered at the end of the trailer, it looks more like one of those boss fights that you would find in Zelda Breath of the Wild. It didn't really look very Sonic-esque. And you know what? I admire that they are being creative, they are taking risks, they are not just playing it safe like Sonic Forces did. What did Sonic Forces give us? It gave us the Egg Dragoon freaking again. It gave us the Death Egg Robot, which wasn't even the Death Egg Robot. So it's like, come on, Sega, at least come up with original names for Eggman's mechs. And then we got Infinite, who was a disappointing villain. I don't need to get into all of that. And that's pretty much it. So already Sonic Frontiers is looking like a much more ambitious game than Sonic Forces ever was. And I like that. That's good. I hope we at least get to have a playable character in the game who isn't just Sonic. Or please don't let that other character be, like, you know, Classic Sonic. Or, like, Classic Sonic should be in his own games. Just knock it off with that already, Sega. And then the custom character, I don't really want to see that again. I would be perfectly okay if that was just a one-time thing. I want to be able to play as Tails or Knuckles in an open world. How fun would it be to fly around as Tails or glide around as Knuckles and scale mountains with his climbing and everything? How fun would that be? I want to be able to do that, and when it comes to the experience of playing as Sonic in an open world, you know, I agree with what everyone else is saying in the sense that it's important that the open world is designed around Sonic's abilities. Granted, we don't really know much about what Sonic's abilities will be like. According to the leaks, he'll have, like, some new ability where he can, like, run around enemies and that'll cause him to be, like, obliterated. That's probably what the energy behind that Sonic is leaving behind in his trail is. There are a lot of questions that we're still waiting to be answered on about this game. Which is not a bad thing, because maintaining that level of mystery around the game will keep fans interested. It'll keep people talking about it in the time leading up to the game's release, as well as the information that we'll continue getting about the game in the meantime. Anyways, some of those questions revolve around the leaks about the game from way back in June, and some of the questions are because of this trailer that was just dropped. What I want to know is, who is this ghost girl that we've been hearing about? We heard about the ghost girl in the leaks, and the trailer pretty much validated the character that the leaks were talking about because of the disembodied voice that was speaking to Sonic during the Sonic Frontiers trailer. It was never shown where the voice was coming from, but I presume it's the Ghost Girl, and I'm wondering if the Ghost Girl is the character from Night of the Werehog, or if it's a completely new character. I honestly lean towards the latter, because I doubt Sega would bring back something from that long ago. I don't think that character was even in the actual game of Sonic Unleashed. It was just Night of the Werehog specifically, and yeah, I doubt it's actually going to be her, unless they, like, give her a different backstory and everything. But you never know, because I've been hearing rumors of Mephiles appearing in the game, and not only that, but to me, it looks like the energy that's appearing around Sonic is very similar to that of the Phantom Ruby. So I'm thinking, like, maybe this new part of the world that Sonic Frontiers is taking place in will perhaps be connected to the origins of the Phantom Ruby. It sort of makes sense because the Chaos Emeralds are at Angel Island, so I would imagine the Phantom Ruby probably comes from somewhere like that too. And we actually got a plot synopsis for the game, and that is from Polygon, which I'm not a big fan of. I actually found the synopsis through Nintendo Life, which got it from, you know, Polygon. And basically, it says that Eggman... So yeah, before we start off with that, actually, yeah, Eggman will be in the game. Which isn't surprising at all. You can't really have a Sonic game without Eggman. I personally can't think of any Sonic games where Eggman didn't appear in any way, shape, or form. I could be wrong, but yeah, nothing comes to mind, and I know a lot about Sonic, so probably hasn't happened. Anyways, Dr. Eggman has, like, created an AI program, I guess, called Sage, and he's using it to, like, hack into the island. So the island has this ancient technology called Starfall. But then the synopsis says that there's more to this technology than it seems. So I'm wondering if what the synopsis is alluding to is that the Starfall technology is mayhaps the framework or from which the Phantom Ruby was made. It would sort of explain a lot of the properties of the Phantom Ruby just in terms of its virtual reality looking magic. It would make perfect sense to me if the Phantom Ruby is like a mixture of technology and magic. How cool would that be? In fact, I really do hope that ends up being the case. I hope that Sega isn't just going to forget about the Sonic Forces story like they have so many of their other games. Fans like it when Sega actually puts effort into putting continuity in Sonic games. They admired that during the days of Sonic Adventure, Sonic Heroes, and even how certain spin-offs like Sonic Battle, Sonic Chronicles, and Shadow the Hedgehog sort of tried to build on that, to expand on that. Even if the ways those games went about that was less than ideal. But anyways, I think this would be a great opportunity for Sega to take some of the shortcomings of Sonic Forces and make them right in a way, if that makes sense. So besides that, synopsis is pretty much saying that Sonic will be racing against time, which is nothing new. He's had to do that before in Generations and Sonic 06 and whatnot. But the synopsis also says that he'll be saving his friends. So to me, that confirms that Sonic and Eggman and the Ghost Girl won't be the only characters in the game. This is sort of implying that we will indeed be seeing characters like Tails, Knuckles, maybe even Amy and other established characters who are established as Sonic's friends. What I'm hopeful for is that these characters will actually be playable. Like, at least make one of the other Sonic characters playable. The addition of Shadow as a playable character in Sonic Forces was kind of like their way of, you know, giving fans what they want without giving them what they actually want. Because when it comes to Shadow, there's absolutely no difference in the way that he plays compared to Sonic. And then the episode Shadow part can pretty much be completed in less than 20 minutes. So that's disappointing. And yeah, sure, you can also play as Shadow in the modern Sonic levels in the main game, but there's really no point in going back and playing those stages, really, if you've already beaten them as Sonic. Plus, just the gameplay of Sonic Forces just isn't really that fun. Whereas in Sonic Frontiers, I'm seeing a lot of potential in this. I think the gameplay could be potentially really good. So please, for the love of God, Sega, just make another Sonic character playable! Please! It can't be that hard to do. Like, this is the sort of thing I've been asking for years. Like, in my old videos when I talked about how Sega should make, like, a 3D environment classic Sonic game, I don't think I literally meant in the sense that they should, like, reproduce the physics of the classic Sonic games in 3D, although I believe that they should take certain principles, like Sonic's gameplay being more momentum-based in 3D than the 3D Sonic games that we've received thus far. So I was hoping to see that sort of equality in a future 3D Sonic game, in addition to having the option of playing as different characters without their gameplay style being different. For instance, you see how Tails and Knuckles and Amy are playable in Sonic Adventure, and then Tails, Knuckles, Shadow, Rouge, and Eggman are playable in Sonic Adventure 2. But the problem is that their gameplay is so different from traditional Sonic gameplay. And it puts us, the players, in a situation where we would rather just be Sonic or Shadow or, well, you know what, Tails was similar enough to Sonic gameplay-wise in the first Sonic Adventure game, but then Sonic Adventure 2 made Tails' gameplay style completely different because he was in a mech the whole time. So that's what I mean, well, as in the opposite of that is what I mean by how I want a 3D environment classic Sonic game. Not necessarily for it to be the exact same as the classic Sonic games, but in 3D. What I'm saying is that I want the best aspects from the classic Sonic games to be in the 3D Sonic titles, pretty much. And what I'm faithful about is Sonic Frontiers being a step in the right direction in that regard. So, in short, multiple playable characters, that would be nice for open world. I'd like to wrap up by addressing the leaks and how that's sort of affecting people's outlooks on the game. While I do think everything that we've been shown about the game is pretty much confirming what the leaks were telling us, aside from Sonic Frontiers being called Sonic Frontiers instead of Sonic Rangers, which can easily be explained by Sonic Rangers simply being a placeholder name. Anyways, the anonymous person who wrote the leaks said that the open world gameplay was kind of boring and that there wasn't much to do in this open space. And this user also referred to the combat in the game as boring, which I really hope isn't the case, but as I was saying, while the information we've gotten so far is pretty much spot on with the leaks, I do think that the leaks were possibly a bit biased. Like, we don't know anything about this anonymous person. We don't know if this person is a Sonic fan who generally enjoys Sonic games. For all we know, Sonic isn't really his cup of tea, and he's just some random tester who just tests random games for a living. Like, we really don't know anything about this person, so for all we know, he could be a little bit biased against Sonic. And not only that, but what he played was just that, an early version of the game. I think he even said in the leaks that it was pretty obvious the game was, or at least the version of the game he was playing was just an early version of it. So a lot of time has passed since then. How the game currently is could be way different from the version he played, let alone the version that, the final version that we'll be getting a year from now. So in other words, my opinion of the game isn't too affected by the leaks. My expectations aren't like super high, but I want what's best for the Sonic series, and I always approach every Sonic game with a level of optimism. Like, I want it to be good. I don't want Sonic games to fail. And I recognize the potential that this game has. This could genuinely be, like, the new standard for the Sonic series. And it's coming out at the perfect time, in the holiday season following, you know, the second Sonic movie, so the stars are pretty much aligning for this game to be a success. I'm seeing a lot of people who generally aren't even that excited by Sonic games praising how this game looks. And I think the trend in the gaming industry of open world Breath of the Wild-esque games is definitely helping with that, so I think that's a good place to end the video. I've pretty much said my piece. Sum it up, I like what I saw from the Sonic Frontiers trailer. I just hope that it's everything we expect out of a great Sonic game, and I want it to feel like a Sonic game, of course. I don't want to play Breath of the Wild, or, you know, Sonic in Breath of the Wild. Like, if I want to play Breath of the Wild, I'll play Zelda Breath of the Wild. You get what I mean? But not hating on the game. I'm just saying. So let me know what you think of the game in the comments. Do you like it? Do you dislike it? Please explain why. And please leave a like. And subscribe, if you will, if you haven't subscribed. This has been the Sammy Classic Sonic Fan. Goodbye, you fricks. Hey everyone, so before I go, I wanted to add one more part to the video, and that is I am actually bringing back hashtag end of video squad. That's something I really liked about, you know, some of the videos that I did like earlier this year. I think it really like helps to like foster community engagement. It was fun, so I kind of want to continue doing that. Yeah, I'm going to be answering a question that was asked me like 5 to 6 months ago from a YouTube person who calls himself Super Mario Ninja, and he's asking how is Haley the Hedgehog doing? How is Bowser Man 101 doing? You know, I feel like I might have answered that before on my channel. At least about Haley the Hedgehog, but I could be wrong though. I might be thinking of Instagram. Basically, Haley's in college right now. She's doing good. She goes to I'm not gonna give away like personal info actually, so I'm not gonna say what college she goes to. But Bowser Man, he's graduated. He went to Purdue, as in past tense. So he doesn't go there anymore. But he graduated and he got a degree in mechanical engineering. So I'm proud of them both. And I wish I could say I get to see them often, that we talk frequently, but that's not really the case. It's not really their fault or anything. It's more so my fault. I'm just a lot more like reclusive these days. Honestly, I've kind of like been this way since like I would say high school, possibly even before that. I would say like around the time back when I like made my YouTube channel, I started to become like more a lot more introverted and everything. I've always been kind of introverted, but basically, yeah, I just don't get to hang out with them that often, or, maybe I could, but I just sort of, don't go out of my way to, spend time with people that often. But, and I know that, what I'm saying is kind of at odds with the background music I chose for while this is, going on, but. So, they're doing good. They're doing good. Leave a comment with the hashtag #EndOfVideoSquad if you want me to answer your comments at the end of the next video. And thank you to everyone who watched all the way through. Yeah, thank you. All right, this has been the Sammy Classic Sonic Fan.